Today, I'm going to show you how to transfer any general orthopedic transfer paper onto your strapping materials, such as leather, C-fold, dacron, and velcro. I'm also going to talk about how you do it and how you don't do it. There's four materials we're going to go over today that you can transfer. The first one is going to be white cowhide, which we've used here already. And this is something that we won't normally do because I can't show you now, but over time it does wear off. So it's not something that we would recommend. We'd recommend just sticking with whatever the color and grain of your cowhide already is, because it will rub off and it just won't look good after a while. And any brace that has leather on it, it's going to blast them. 6 months if it's a pediatric, years if it's for adults, it's just better to just leave it as regular leather, so rid of that. C-fold, you can transfer onto C-fold as well, but for this color, we would probably just use black C-fold because it would look better than this faded color here. It's really up to you if you want to transfer your C-fold. We prefer to just leave it the whatever color we get, black, white, beige, whatever color, but you can transfer it if you think it looks better, and that's up to you. You can also transfer, as a lot of you probably already know, is your standard loop Velcro. Very easy to transfer. It comes out looking pretty good usually, if you do it right. And one thing about it is that when you do transfer onto this, if you're going to have anything sewn onto it, you want to transfer before, because if you sew on it and then transfer, you'll tend to melt the stitching off, and it's basically going to mess up your strap. You're going to have to start over, and no one wants to do that. You can also transfer onto a dacron strap, but again, before you sew anything, transfer onto it, then sew. You're going to melt your stitches. You're going to have a bad time. So I guess we'll go ahead and show you how to transfer onto loop Velcro first. So one thing you'll want to notice about transferring these materials is that they shrink, and I'm going to go ahead and actually cut this Velcro down just so I can show you that it will shrink when it's ironed on. And so I'm going to go ahead and take this ruler and measure it out to about 12 inches. It's about a foot long piece of that Velcro. And for your setup here, you're going to want the ironing board, and it's always a good idea to put some just sticky back hook Velcro right onto your board, so that when you stick your loop Velcro on there, it'll hold it in place for you at the start. You won't have to worry about it moving around nearly as much. And that is very handy to have. Now, you're going to want to take your transfer paper and lay it out. And you always want to cut it a little bit wider, and you'll see in a minute why, is that as you transfer this loop Velcro, it will tend to not only shrink, but it'll also warp either up or down, basically away from the center line that you have now. So you want to cut it extra wide, like about this wide should be good, maybe 2.5 to 3 times the width of your regular Velcro, just to keep it in line. Make sure you're covered in case it does move. So stick it down to your adhesive hook, lay this down on top of it. And you want to start your iron behind the line, because you need to make sure that you're applying heat evenly from start to finish. So if you start over here, you're going to leave that edge isn't going to get the same amount of heat that the rest of your strap is going to get. So starting from back here, you want to set your iron down, but as soon as you set your iron down, you want to start moving it. And some people move it straight up and down, some people move it in circles. I like to do this nice little wrist motion back and forth. And you just want to move very slowly, but keep it moving. Because if you stop moving, then you're going to melt your strap, you're going to melt the paper onto the Velcro strap, and you're going to have a bad time. So again, just keep it moving. And just back and forth, up and down, in circles, whatever you want to do. And it's going to take you a little while to get to the end, and I might actually be moving too fast. Yeah, I'm moving way too fast. But you can pick up this paper here and follow where you're transferring, and that will show you what your transfer is looking like, so you know if you need to speed up or slow down or anything like that. And so you can see now that I've slowed down, the transfer is coming out a lot darker, it's looking a lot better. And again, just keep it moving, don't let it melt on you. You can see that's coming out much nicer. And always around your edges, you're typically going to have just, your edges will typically not be consistent with the remainder of your strap, so always cut your piece a little bit extra long, just to be sure, just to be safe, because you don't want to have to start this over. It's better to just waste, you know, 2 cents worth of Velcro than waste an entire another couple minutes just getting set for this. So just keep it moving, keep it moving. There's the end of our strap. So as you can see, if you move too slow, move too fast, that's what you're going to get. If you keep it at just the right speed, you expect to get this kind of very nice looking consistency. And now, where did I put my ruler? Here we go. Go ahead and see just how long the strap is now that we're done. So we started at 12 inches, and we are now at 11 and a half. So, assuming it's consistent, you can expect to lose about a half inch every foot. It's not a whole lot, but it could be enough to mess up your strap, so always go a little bit longer because your edges won't be consistent and because your straps are going to shrink. And next, we will move on to our dacron. And this little scrap here measures in at about 6 3/8. So, again, we're going to take our transfer paper, cut out a section that's a bit wider than our material. And this won't stick to our hook Velcro, so it doesn't really matter that much where we place it. But I'm going to go ahead and set it down. And again, to the center of our board here. Set it down like that, and again, just start moving. Make sure you apply good pressure to the entirety of your strap. Just keep it moving. Keep moving on down. Once you reach the edge and your iron's a fairly safe distance away, you pick it up. Still moving too fast. It is a very slow process transferring these straps, and you tend to have to move always pretty much slower than what you think you're going to have to move. And it's annoying, and eventually your forearms may start to get tired if you don't do this very much. You're going to want to move faster, but don't move faster, or you're just going to end up starting over. Again, we can check. I think a much better transfer after we slow down. And one thing I do want to point out is that you cannot start over, you cannot go back and retransfer the strap, or you're just going to get a double image, and it's pretty much just not going to look good, so you really only get one shot at this. Very difficult to realign it, and pretty much impossible to keep it realigned once you start over. It's going to move on you. So, again, moving too fast, moving at just the right speed, you'll get that very nice looking image. And now let's check our length. Started at 6 3/8, and now we're at 5 5/8. So we've lost what, a good 3/4 almost of an inch off of that? Is that what I'm getting here? So again, dacron shrinks a lot more than your Velcro does. Cut your dacron straps extra long. We've also lost some width. This started out at 1 inch, and now we are at, what does that look like, 3/4. So remember that when you're cutting your straps, is that they're going to shrink length and width-wise. And so there you have it.